Good evening everyone, this is Kaifu here. Today I have game 2 in the series for FoWTCG World Championship Grand Prix held in Tokyo. On my left side we have Carlson, and on my right side we have Aziz. For me to easier to say his name, let's call him A for now. This will be the final series for FoWTCG World Championship. If you guys want to watch top 4, top 2 and final so on, you should go to the official website because I'm already 3 weeks behind our FoWTCG Championship already, so I don't want to drag it on so more. So if you guys want to watch it, you can go online and watch the official website. So let's see what happens. Back to Carlson's turn. Carlson is tapping producing 1 magic stone at the moment. At the moment he has 2 magic stone open and 1 werewolf, and activating Thunder Rider when killing an Elf Priest played by A last turn. I don't know if that was a good play. Like I said before in the previous game, using Thunder too early, killing a non-problematic card is not a ideal move, because that, what can a priest do? Yes, a priest can do combo wombo thing with musketeers, but however, the musketeers are the real issue at the moment, because that they have high stats. However, but they have low defense. Until the Puss and Boot judgment, the defense remained 500 and 400 for the other two musketeers. Arthas is the one on musketeer has 800 defense, but using the musketeers like your 3 drops, they are really easy to kill with Thunder, so you should use the Thunder against those one, because those are the real problems. With when all 3 musketeers are on the battlefield, Puss and Boot gets a free J activate. Paying 2, playing a musketeer on the field from A. That musketeer has the ability to do piercing damage, so meaning whenever it attacks and the defender is defending an attack, the piercing damage does the difference from the attack point to the monster's defense point. Back to Carlson's turn, producing 1 magic stone. Let's see what he can do. 3 magic stone open, he can do maybe play a Garrow while he's playing 3 for now, and playing Pale Moon. I'm not quite sure about this. Wasting a Pale Moon too early in the game again, I think another majority misplay. Why I'm saying this is because that Pale Moon can actually get you a J activate on your little red riding hood to do more damage. And using Pale Moon to defend yourself for what? Maybe against the 500 burn damage? It doesn't matter in the long run, because that if you're in the winning position, taking 500 point damage shouldn't matter too much. But now back to Ace, and let's see what he can do. He drew for his turn already, now he's going to recover phase. Tapping his Puss in Boot to produce another magic stone. Let's see what option he has. At the moment, the driving system still goes to Carlson with fuel present and life point advantage as well. As for A unit, has 1 musketeer on the field with 2500 life point left. Let's see what can A do in this situation. A is thinking about his move at the moment. He has lots of plays and so on. Let's see what he can do. Paying 3, play Arthas on the battlefield. Using Arthas skill when it comes to play, search for a resonant addition and add it on to it if you have a Puss Boot as your ruler. If not, add it to your hand instead. He actually added the Crefix. Crefix has the ability that when this is attached to a vampire, make 1000 attack and 1000 defense, so an instant kill to vampire. However, a second ability, if it is not a vampire, it can't be attacked and is unaffected by spells or abilities which can target it. So give me protection. Attacking with one of musketeers, doing 700 points of damage, leaving 3300 life point left to Carlson. Back to Carlson's turn now, drawing for turn, recover phase. Let's see what can Carlson do in this situation. I did make a cut out of this scene because that there was some issue ruling, so it took a couple minutes, so that's why I cut it off. So let's see what can Carlson do now in this situation. He's facing an Arthas, which is an 8-8 resonator. And let's see what he can do. Tapping his little red riding hood, producing another magic stone. Let's see now. Tapping is the werewolf, attacking the musketeer, I'm assuming. Let's see what can A do in this situation. Oh, he actually took the damage. Destroying the musketeer, so both players will lose their resonators. But however, since there's a moon card on the field, Carlson doesn't take the 500 burn damage. Attacking directly, and Aziz decided not to block with it. I don't understand why. If he blocks with it, he'll be fine, because with that addition onto him, he can't be attacked anyway. Even Carlson dropped the Garrett, which has swiftness. So let's see what can Aziz do in this situation. He has somewhat a lot of play because of with the hand advantage he has at the moment. I see Cinderella slippers and so on. Tapping Puss and Boot to produce one magic stone. Let's see what happens from here. Paying 2 to play another musketeer on the field. This musketeer has the ability to produce one green wheel for each musketeer on the battlefield. He has 2 at the moment. Using Silver Bullet, casting it to search for a musketeer and add to his hand. Well, not musketeer, but search for any green res in it. But knowing this deck, you usually search for a musketeer. Tapping, putting him onto the battlefield. Wait. Something's not right here. He'll only pay 1. He already used the 2 wheels that have been produced already, so he has to use the extra last one. So I think there was a miscalculation when coming cards on the field. When it comes to play, produce 3 magic wheel and playing after the battlefield. I think this was a misplay because that extra open magic stone could matter in the long run, but let's see what happens. Oh, Carlson would respond with the impalement to bounce it back, but unfortunately it can't work because that it's not chasing to the ability, it's chasing when it's trying to attach. Because Carlson didn't declare to chase, meaning the effect is already resolved. So meaning it's already resolving, meaning he has to faint, wait for everything to resolve and put it onto it. So meaning Carlson has missed his opportunity to return it back to the owner's hand. So meaning Pale Moon can't bounce it back at all. So let's see what can Carlson, what can Carlson do in this situation. He's facing 4 musketeer. 2 of them is 800 attack, 800 defense. 2 of them is 5-5, and not only that, with 2 musketeer on the field, he can actually reduce Puss and Boot judgment by 6, attacking directly for 800 point damage. Oh no, attacking the werewolf to reduce the resource that what Carlson can do by eliminating his battle formation. Having less resonator will cost Carlson the game, because the reason is that fire, mostly fire deck, usually rely on a lot of early game punch. If they lose all their resource in the early game, they can't do much in the late game, because in the late game they already use too much resource, like early before using early thunder on the priest when he shouldn't have. Not saying he did a bad move or whatever, but since it is his choice. Oh, playing Cinderella Slipper. Now that did matter now, because that Cinderella Slipper can actually make 400 attack, 400 defense. Now because that usually it will cost 2 to play the musketeer onto the battlefield, because he miscalculated and leaving 1 black magic stone open, which cost A to play the slippers onto the battlefield. Now I don't think Carlson knew about it, so I could say it was Carlson's fault for not noticing that there was a miscalculation about it, but I'm not going to judge anything at the moment. So let's see how it turns out. Does that miscalculation favor Aziz at the moment, or does miscalculation will help Carlson in the long run? But mostly it will be a really really hard situation for Carlson at the moment, because he's in a situation that he only has 1 resonator and 1 pale moon, and can't play another pale moon on the battlefield because that he already has 1 on the field. So he has to somehow get rid of that pale moon to actually J-activate if he wants to. Let's see what can Carlson do in this situation. At the moment Carlson is facing 4 musketeers. 2 of them is a vanilla pretty much, already used their ability, but also he's facing 2 musketeers already have protection. You can't attack it, you can't attack it with spells or abilities, and and not only that, A has the spell card called Musketeer Bayonet. He can attach to it to one of the Arthas that which has first strike and piercing, and not only it gains 400 attack as well. So meaning you can't attack it. It has a piercing and first strike. What more can you ask? Tapping his ruler produce 1 magic stone. Let's see what can Carlson do in this situation. With 5 magic slots open, he can do a lot of plays, but however, not enough plays to actually put it back in his advantage because that he already lost too much resource in the early game. Because he lost the 2 werewolves, wasting a thunder too early, and so on. He only has a few cards he can play with. Let's see, paying 2 to play. Let's see what he can play. Another werewolf. I think it's called Werewolf Full Moon. Was it? I can't exactly remember the names. Next he's playing Putting Fire, can deal 700 point damage to a player or 1000 point damage to a human resident onto the battlefield. But Carlson is doing 700 damage, dealing 1700 left to putting A back to 1300 life points. Now I don't know if that mattered at all because now all the werewolf on the field has swiftness and first strike. But however, if Carlson declares an attack with it, he will be defenseless. He's passing his turn. Really, really smart play because that if he attacks recklessly, he has no outs against the musketeers because the musketeers just ram into it and kill it, leaving Carlson defenseless and no resource on the battlefield to attack with. Back to A's turn. Playing Gretel on the field, producing 1 magic stone. Now, if I'm seeing correctly, I'm pretty sure A want to actually judgment because the Puss in Boots is still in the recover position and has 2 musketeers on the field, can reduce to 6 cost to actually to 3 cost to actually put a musketeer on the field, but Jade activate on the field. Sorry for that. And if my assumption was right, he DJ activate, putting the musketeer on the field. This musketeer has quite a good ability. All musketeer onto the battlefield, all except for itself, it gains 400 attack and 400 defense. Now this musketeer is attacking for 900 point of damage. Not only that, the J ruler has target attack and piercing. Oh, Carlson respond with Pale Moon, bouncing one of the musketeer back to his hand. Let's see what can Carlson do. Oh, passing his turn. A passed his turn. It was playing the safe side, not to go recklessly against it. What a really smart play. Back to Carlson's turn now. Let's see what he can do. He's thinking his choice at the moment. He can't actually do much against the musketeer because the musketeer are quite huge at the moment because of the J rule on the battlefield. Paying 3. I'll have to play Pale Moon on the field, which can get a free J activate on Little Red Riding Hood. Targeting the musketeer, but the musketeer survives. The reason is because 800 point damage isn't enough to destroy a 900 point defense. Why is it 900, you're wondering? Because the J rule is onto the battlefield. J rule not only buffs attack, but buffs defense as well by 400, so making a 900 defense, surviving with 100 point left. Not much that Carlson can do in this situation. He can attack with his Little Red Riding Hood, but however, Little Red Riding Hood will get countered by everything else. All the musketeers are quite big, so meaning he won't be able to survive this. Won't be able to survive the battlefield if the Little Red Riding Hood attacks. Not only that, the werewolf is only 5/5, so he can't do anything. So passing his turn back to A's turn. Back to A's turn. Let's see what he can do. Paying 2 to play the musketeer being bounced back to his hand. Now he has 4 floating on the field, using 2 of them to play silver bullet. Let's see what he can search for. Search for another musketeer and produce a magic wheel if it's placed on the battlefield. Using the last 2 wheel, I'm assuming, because he already used 2 for the silver bullet. Yep, using the last 2 to produce 5 magic wheels, playing 2 to actually produce a magic stone. Oh, getting aggressive now. Using the last one. Oh, Pumpkin Witch. Pumpkin Witch gives all resident onto the battlefield swiftness and flying, meaning Carlson cannot defend it. Even Carlson has a Pale Moon on the field, he only can return 1 back. Oh, Carlson scooping it up. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Talk to you guys next time. Peace.